In the select clause, you can code an expression that includes one or more arithmetic operators. An expression is a combination of column names, numbers, and operators, and evaluates to a single value. This select statement includes an arithmetic expression which is the result of the addition of the list 1 column and the list 2 column. Let's execute this statement. And let's compare this result set with the numbers table. There are several other arithmetic operators you can use in the arithmetic expressions. This example shows the addition and subtraction operators. Note that when you code a value for a number, you don't need to enclose the number in quotes. This example shows the multiplication, the division, the integer division, and the modulo operators. In this example, the second column contains the product of list 1 and 2. The third column contains the quotient of list 1 and 3. Then, the fourth column uses the DIV operator to return the integer quotient of the division between list 1 and 4. The fifth column uses the modulo operator to return the remainder of the division between list 1 and 5. Finally, the sixth column uses the percent sign, which is an alternative way to code the modulo operator. The modulo operator only works with integer numbers. The reason for that is because the mathematical notion of remainder is only applicable to integer division. Note that MySQL automatically converts the quotient of list 1 and 3 from an integer value to a decimal value. In mathematics, order of precedence is a rule used to clarify which procedures should be performed first in a given mathematical expression. In arithmetic expressions, MySQL performs multiplication, division, DIV and MOD operations first, then it performs addition and subtraction operations. The operations in an expression are performed from left to right. Let's see how this works in a statement. In this example, MySQL performs multiplication, division, DIV and MOD operations from left to right first. So it performs first this operation, then this one, and finally this one. Then it performs addition and subtraction operations from left to right, which means that one, minus that one, minus that one, plus that one. Let's execute this statement. If you wish to override the order of precedence rule, you can use parentheses to specify how an expression is evaluated. Let's see how. You can use parentheses in an expression to specify how an expression is evaluated and override the order of precedence rule. In cases like this one, MySQL evaluates the expressions in the innermost sets of parentheses first, followed by the expressions in other sets of parentheses. So, this is evaluated first because it's the first innermost sets of parentheses. Then comes this, and finally this. Within each set of parentheses, MySQL evaluates the expression from left to right in the order of precedence. Here is a simpler example that shows how parentheses and the order of precedence affect the evaluation of an expression. Here, the expressions in the second and third columns both perform the same operations. These expressions use one column name and two literal values for numbers. When MySQL evaluates the expression in the second column, it performs the multiplication operation before the addition operation, because multiplication comes before addition in the order of precedence. When MySQL evaluates the expression in the third column, though, it performs the addition operation first, because it's enclosed in parentheses. Because of this, these two expressions return different values, as shown in the result set. If you want, you can also use parentheses to clarify an expression even if they are not needed for the expression to be evaluated properly. Here, for instance, the parentheses are unnecessary, as multiplication still has precedence without them. However, you should avoid cluttering your SQL statements with unnecessary parentheses. By default, a column in the result set is given the same name as the column in the base table. If the column is based on a calculated value, MySQL uses the expression for the calculated value as the column name. Since the expressions for many calculated values can be cumbersome, you can specify a substitute name known as a column alias for the column. This example shows what happens when you don't assign an alias to a calculated column. Let's have a look at how to code them. This select statement assigns a column alias to the last column which uses an expression. To assign a column alias, you code the column specification followed by the S keyword and the new name as shown by this example. In this statement, the last column uses an expression, and the resulting column is given the name MyExpression. Although the S keyword is optional, it's recommended you code it for readability. This is another select statement that renames the columns in the result set. Here, the statement creates an alias of amount to pay for the amount to pay column, paid for the amount paid column, and coupon for the total coupon column. To include a space in the alias for the first column, this statement encloses that alias in single quotes.